When you hear the air attack warning, you and your family must take cover.
Good. It was a.
Said it rubbish.
Yeah. Well.
Oh yeah.
You did though.
No. It was.
I don't tell lies.
No. It wasn't. It wasn't rubbish. It was just. It wasn't as good as.
You were spent.
It wasn't as good as other years that I've been on. You know.
You were spent. So, you went hard the day before.
Yes. That's what it. Basically, that's what I meant. Obviously, we went out right after the Cass game. We got a win against Cass, so we were all pretty pumped. Went out. Seen you in town.
Yep.
Yeah.
Good, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. Yeah.
Pumped the tunes out.
Yeah, it was pumping.
Paul Aiton came up and, hey man, I love your music, man.
I didn't know he was Welsh.
Yeah.
So
he's playing for Wales, isn't he? Yeah. World Cup.
So obviously then we started again at 9:30 in the morning. There was one or two lads feeling sorry for themselves, and all the Aussies went home, so there wasn't a full team there. So yeah, it was good, but it, in terms of a turnout, it was pretty standard.
Pretty standard.
Mm.
It's not good, is it?
No, not really, no.
It's a bit of a disappointment, but, really.
Like I said, the night before was great, though.
Yeah,
the night before we all had a good night.
Sunday.
But for the actual Monday that we all sort of rugby players like to go hard on, it wasn't really.
Why didn't you get dressed up?
You beat me to it.
Yeah. what can I say?
Did you get a taxi home, okay?
No, it took me about 45 minutes. It took me to get home. I actually walked up to a.
You need to explain what you got dressed up as. Well, obviously,
I went dressed as a tramp. And I went dressed as a tramp.
You like a bank again?
Someone tweeted me that actually. And all lads went to Wakey about 9 o'clock. So I was just stood. Obviously, I don't live too far from Headingley, so I was stood in the middle of Headingley, dressed as a tramp on my own. And where the taxi was, but was outside a tree, I walked up to it. Obviously, you see me coming in the headlights, and I put my window down. I said, "Can I get a taxi, please, back to where I live?" And he said, "No, mate, no." I went, "Why?" I started laughing at him because I just thought, "How ridiculous is this? You can't get a taxi." So I went down to the next car, and he must have seen me getting blown out by him in front. So he just went, "No, mate, you're not getting in." And they were just like. Oh.
Tonight,
yeah.
Keith is on fire.
And then eventually, third taxi sort of after they'd went.
Felt sorry for you.
He sort of felt sorry for me, but then asked me for £8 up front, which is normally a £3 taxi. So, and I was still trying to explain to him, we were on a rugby do, and it was we were all dressed up, and he just gave me one word answer. So I thought, oh, sorry, yeah, I'll explain myself to you.